Exploratory study to determine some of the risk factor on the prevalence of chronic kidney disease in the area of Bajo Lempa, El Salvador. This work was done by Rafael Gomez Escoto, Raúl Enríquez, and Pedro Ramos from the University of El Salvador, and David Imo from the University of Koblenz-Landau in Germany. Resume. The present study was undertaken in order to determine some of the risk factor on the anomalous high prevalence of chronic kidney disease, CKD, in residents of rural communities in the area of Bajo Lempa on the coast of El Salvador. As critical areas were identified six communities, namely El Zamorano, Ciudad Romero, Nueva Esperanza, La Canoa, La Limonera, and Sisiguayo, where a survey has been conducted with a sample of selected community members and whose activities are mainly related to farming. Additionally, we collect soil samples both in crop as in household areas in order to determine the presence, concentration, and spatial distribution of heavy elements such as chrome, iron, nickel, copper, zinc, cadmium, and lead using the technique of X-ray fluorescence. Methodology, physical context. The Bajo Lempa region are located at the coastal zone that form the Lempa River basin, known as the Bajo Lempa, bounded on the south by the Pacific Ocean and north by the volcano Chinchontepec and volcanic cordillera. The area is predominantly agricultural vocation, traditionally cultivating cotton, sugarcane, corn, and others, and with an emerging development in the textile industry. Survey. A survey was randomly applied by choosing a sample of 2%, about 200 surveys, of the population of the six rural communities with a total of about 10,000 inhabitants. The survey was performed in different field trips to each one of the considered communities, making visits house to house and identifying resource, logistic, and scheduling of project activities. With support from the Faculty of Natural Science and Mathematics from the University of El Salvador, the University of Koblenz-Landau in Germany, and the Public Health Ministry of El Salvador. Between September and December 2012, about 10 to 15 interviews per visit were conducted by special trained personnel, selecting randomly interviewees that complete the requirements of being adults and expressing their will to participate in the survey. Presence, concentration, and spatial distribution of nephrotoxic heavy metals. Additionally, we investigated concentrations of heavy metals like cadmium, chrome, arsenic, copper, and lead in soil samples. To do this, were analyzed by X-ray fluorescence about 65 soil samples, of which 34 were extracted from areas where the local planted corn, beans, sesame, sugarcane, vegetables, etc. Another 31 samples are from the residential area of Ciudad Romero and the neighborhood of El Zamorán in the Bajo Lempa region in El Salvador. Results. The population in the six studies communities of Bajo Lempa is composed by low-income families mainly devoted to subsistence agricultural work, with low educational levels and a poor diet consisting primarily of grains, corn, rice, beans, and coffee. The illiteracy rate found among the surveyed population was almost double in comparison with the illiteracy rate reported by the, for the country by Minet Digestic in 2008, which was 16%. About 50% of the families interviewed are composed by five or more members and survive on $100 a month or even less. Those inhabitants are primarily displaced Salvadorian people because of Civil War 1979-1992, coming from the mountainous area at the north of the country, who were relocated in the coastal area of Bajo Lempa more than 20 years ago. They should self-accommodate to an average annual temperature of 35 degrees in the coastal zone And they have even to face the behavior of the main watershed of El Salvador, the Lempa River, which often generates moderate to severe flooding throughout the whole area. A significant percentage of the surveyed population claims to have reduced or completely stopped smoke and alcohol consumption, reporting a 76% of non-smoker and 75% of non-alcoholic. However, by the nature of the survey, face-to-face interviews, it is difficult to know if everyone is declaring the truth. Only about 50% of the surveyed population state to consume about 1 liter of water per day. But currently, 93% of the families have a system of tap water service since 2002. Agricultural activities demand a lot or even too much physical effort, and 67% of the population surveyed works on average of 4 to 6 hours per day without adequate water intake. The most used agrochemicals by the local farmers are the ethanol, paraquat, and glyphosate as herbicides, karate, bolaton, and tamarone as insecticides, and bifolan as fertilizer. The 84% of respondents state to participate in the process of application of pesticides, having worked in this occupation for 10 years or more. But 63% of them do not use absolutely any kind of protection clothing. On the other hand, 68% of respondents say that the empty cans and other materials used in the process of dilution and application of agrochemicals are often left in field, 52% more or less, or simply burned, 26%, while only 2% recognize that the cans will be washed and reused. Around 24% of the population surveyed report having been diagnosed with early symptoms of CKD, while about 19% of the respondents state that they have been definitively diagnosed in some of the stage of development of CKD, so that 77% of patients initially diagnosed with kidney failure symptoms were subsequently confirmed with CKD. From those patients diagnosed and under medical treatment for CKD, about 15% is currently being subject to dialysis treatments. The 88% of respondents diagnosed with CKD are farmers. The most affected communities, according to this study, are the Zamorano and Sisiguayo, with 24% of CKD prevalence, and they are followed by Ciudad Romero with 21% of prevalence. On the other hand, 85% of CKD cases are concentrated in people older than 32 years. There is observed a gender-dependent behavior of CKD prevalence. From 34 cases of CKD detected in this study, 79% are men. From the interviewed population declaring have been diagnosed with CKD, a certain percentage also state otherwise to have associated other chronic disease, such as diabetes, anemia, hypertension, allergies, and overweight. However, by the nature of the survey, it is unknown whether this chronic disease precedes and could become a risk factor for CKD, either they were subsequent or concurrent with CKD. However, 55% of CKD observed cases do not present symptoms related with other chronic disease, as they declare. Risk factors for CKD identified in this study are consistent with those widely described in various scientific articles on the subject. Among the risk factors identified in the available literature, there are some that increase a person's susceptibility to CKD, called susceptibility factors. There are others who can directly cause the disease, known as initiation or trigger factors, and others that may accelerate and aggravate kidney damage called progression factors. Results in regard to the presence, concentration, and spatial distribution of free nephrotoxic heavy metals, cadmium, copper, and lead. The region of Bajo Lempa is historically a place where cotton was grown in the decades of 70s and 80s, and presumably soils were highly contaminated with toxic elements from pesticides. In studies conducted by the Ministry of Health, have reported that many CKD patients living in the area of Bajo Lempa were direct or indirect in contact for years with pesticides such as paraquat, glyphosate, and others. In general, the concentration of the three nephrotoxic metals, cadmium, lead, and copper, measured in soil samples, are up to 97% below the tolerable maximum limits established by regulatory agencies like the Canadian Council of Ministers of the Environment, CCME, and the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA. These results suggest that for the period of collection of the sample, October, November, and December 2012, there was no significant contamination of the elements cadmium, copper, and lead, both in residential and crops areas. However, it should be noted that, for example, the values of concentration of copper are very close to the recommended limit. By the spatial distribution of the nephrotoxic elements, similar behavior is observed for the three identified elements. The minimum value of lead concentration are observed in residential area less than 1.3 milligram per kilogram. The maximum values of concentration of the three elements are seen in areas where planting corn crops. Making a comparison between the three maps obtained, one can see the difference in the distribution of concentration for cadmium, copper, and lead in the study area. Conclusions about the survey. It has been verified that the habit to consuming low quantities of water is very common, especially for persons engaged in work of intense physical exertion and exposure to the sun, just as the agricultural activities, which certainly are performed mostly by men. Water intake should be a minimum of 6 liters per day, otherwise might cause a state of chronic dehydration and therefore constitute a risk factor for kidney damage. There is noticeable difference between genders regarding the prevalence of CKD. The gender-dependent behavior of CKD seems to be directly related to occupational risk factor. The 79% of people reported in this study with CKD are men, who are subject to underlying risk factors such as occupational exposure to sunlight and the use and time of use of pesticides. Everything seems to indicate that exposure to agrochemical and some heavy metals are trigger factors of kidney damage, while the dehydration and heat stress might constitute determining factors for the progression of CKD. Whereas age and progression of hypertension and other chronic disease are variables that are traditional risk factor and related to the progression of CKD, it can be reasonably assumed that contact with other nephrotoxic agents, as the use of pesticide, prolonged sun exposure, and reduced water intake, are also three factors that converge to cause kidney damage and help to explain the high prevalence of CKD in men than in women in the studied area. Additionally, it was observed a common practice to Salvadorian population, who used to resort to self-medication in order to address some dysfunction, such as muscle ache, urinary tract infections, common colds, or digestive disorders, leading to abuse of analgesic, diuretics, and antibiotics, which are freely sold on the market and are also considered as CKD risk factors. Nevertheless, this initial conclusion still must be verified and complemented with toxicological, epidemiological, and clinic studies in order to identify the chemical formulation able to cause kidney damage under the described conditions, but also to know the exposure pathways and the kind of specific damage to the kidney tissues leading to CKD. Conclusions in regards to the presence, concentration, and spatial distribution of three nephrotoxic heavy metals, cadmium, copper, and lead. The highest concentration of nephrotoxic heavy metals were found in the corn growing areas. On average, nephrotoxic metal concentration were higher in the crops areas compared with those found in the household areas. The highest concentration of nephrotoxic metals determined in this research are below acceptable levels in residential soil and crops, according to the standards of the Canadian Council of Ministers of Environment, CCME. Consequently, one cannot speak of heavy metal pollution in the studied area. It is not possible to establish a direct correlation between the presence and concentration of heavy metals in the soils of the studied area with the prevalence of chronic kidney disease among the locals. Recommendations. First of all, extend this study to the entire coastal area of the country, with emphasis on agricultural communities particularly affected by an increased CKD prevalence, delving into the statistical evaluation of the identified risk factors. Monitoring the quality of drinking water in order to determine which one of the really risk factors leading to CKD by the study population, if it is because they are not drinking enough water or that they are just drinking contaminated water. Measurements of contaminant in soil, air, and food, considering both spatial and temporal variability. The identified risk factors such as the exposure to heat, the occupational dehydration, and the abuse of potentially nephrotoxic medication, such as diuretic, analgesic, and antibiotics, should be a main focus of national preventive health programs. Additionally, it seems to be urgent to initiate capacity building programs for farmers in order to convert the national agriculture to the sustainable bioproduction, reducing or eliminating as far as possible the use of commercial pesticides of which there is evidence of its toxicity to the environment and the human health. Thank you very much.